me talk about geometric real quick. This is just a sequence, okay? Not the series. So remember, I'm only talking about a list of numbers. I'm not talking about the sum of them. Sequence versus series. Series is the sum of them. So geometric sequence is another pattern that you can see, that happens. Let me do an easy one first. 3, 6, 12, 24. So I have this pattern, or I have this sequence, and I have to find or represent, I want to represent a formula for this, but I also want to recognize the pattern. If there is one, then, you know, maybe I could use one of these formulas. Like, is it arithmetic? I could use that one. If it's geometric, I have another formula. So let's see, what am I doing to get from 3 to 6? Now, remember that you're not going to know which section you're in. So I can add 3 to get to 6. But if I add 3 to 6, I'm not going to get 12. So that's not the pattern. But I could also multiply 3 times 2 to get to 6, which also is consistent for the rest of the sequence to get from one term to the other. Another way to determine is to take the second term and divide it by the first. Take the third term and divide it by the second. So I'm dividing numbers instead of subtracting, which goes along with multiplication. So we have what's called a common ratio, which is represented by R, which in this case is 2. Not always 2, just in this case, right? So the common ratio here is positive 2, which it could also be negative. If it were negative, then the signs would alternate. But that means that I can actually identify the nth term of this geometric sequence. So now, what is the formula for that? What is the formula for the nth term of a geometric sequence? Geometric gets interesting too. Geometric sequence. So the nth term of a geometric sequence is dependent on the first term times the common ratio to the n minus 1. This is my formula. So you need the first term and you need the common ratio to determine the nth term, which is also not difficult. We already found the common ratio for this one. So all I have to do is find the first term, which in this case, again, not hard. A1 is the first term, which is 3. And now I can find the nth term, 3 times the common ratio 2 raised to the n minus 1. And there's my nth term. Now, verify it, right? Let me just verify. Do a quick check to make sure that this is true. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's find the fourth term, A4. So I'm replacing all my n's with 4, and I should get 24 at the end of the day. So let's see. 3 times. So order of operations here, be very careful. That's why I put parentheses around the common ratio. This exponent only applies to this. It does not apply to this. So I need to do this part first. And then the last thing would be to multiply by this coefficient. So 2 to the third, right, is 8. 8 times 3 is 24. So that matches what I should get for the fourth term. So here's the nth term of this geometric series. Sequence, not series. It would be a series if I were adding. We'll get there. Let me do one more. Not difficult, right? As long as you know the formulas, you have to recognize the situation, but let's do 2, 1, 1/2, 1/4. And there's alternate. Dot. So I have this sequence, and you're asked to basically identify the nth term of this sequence. So is there a pattern that we know or not? No. If it's not arithmetic or geometric, I have to play around and find a pattern. But let's see if it's one of the two that we know. To get from 2 to negative 1, I mean, I could subtract 3, but that's not obviously staying consistent here. Let's see if ratio or multiplication works. So negative 1 divided by 2 is negative 1. And 1/2 divided by negative 1 is also negative 1. So let me see if I'm multiplying negative 1/2 times each term to get to the next one. Is it common ratio? Yeah, 1/2 times negative 1/2 is negative 1/4. So it looks like I have a common ratio of negative 1/2 So it's geometric. And then the first term is 2. And notice that the common ratio doesn't have to be a whole number. It could also be a fraction. So if you're dividing by a same number, remember that you also have to represent it by whatever you multiply. So technically, I'm dividing by negative 2, but that's the same thing as multiplying by negative 1/2. And the common ratio is whatever number you're multiplying each term by to get to the next one. So the nth term of this geometric sequence is the first term times the common ratio raised to the n minus 1. So they're not hard, right? The arithmetic and geometric sequence.